Friends, are you ready for this? In Tinkercad Sim Lab, we can now bind keys with motors. I got a cool car we can drive, so let's get cracking. Friends, real quickly before we start, I want to show you resources and the blog. This just dropped today. There are tons of awesome notes from Christian here. You really should check this all out. Of course, right now I want to get you building, so we're going to go back to home, choose create, and 3D design. I'm going to call mine remote car and press enter. Of course, I like to name it so I can find it later. Right now, I'm going to keep the build area and the car tiny. We'll make larger projects with this later. I'm going to bring out the cube. I'm going to just simply stretch this down, put the number 8 for how thin I want it to be, and I'm going to keep it at 20. I'm going to choose this for 4. Once again, I'm making this car tiny just because it's fun to drive on this work plane. Of course, once you've built your original one, you can make it larger, add courses, and all sorts of things. Next up, we're going to make an awesome tire with a brand new sketch tool. I'm bringing this in and I'm trying to drop it on a 20 by 20 spot. Notice that lines up perfect. And then I'm going to make a tiny tire. So this is 10 millimeters. I'm going to simply go out 5 millimeters in each direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then connect it. Now that we've got this awesome diamond that you could adjust, if you miss, you just move them to the right spots, we can double click it. It turns those into bezier curves and our tire is done. How cool is that? Perfectly smooth. Let's make it 1 millimeter thick. And now let's bring it closer to our car. We do want to put it on this wall. Let's hit C for cruise and simply drop it on that side. I'm going to click to cancel out that work plane, click on the tire and do D to drop, so that way it is the right height. Now I'm going to grab them both, do L for align, make the tire the boss, and if we zoom in, of course we want it to be at the center. I'm going to move this away one click or 1 millimeter, and I'm going to nudge it back a few clicks so my tire is to the front. Now friends, we can switch to the awesome Sim Lab. And we can bring out the motor. I'm gonna cruise it right onto the tire. Then we can grab those two parts, choose L for align. Of course, on the vertical side, we want it aligned, and we also want it aligned in this direction as well. I like to click the corner so it's easier to spot the middle in that direction. Now that we've got our motor dropped, we need to take the orange one and connect it to the tire. Notice it stayed that color, not gray. And we need to connect this one to the body of the car. If it does not get that color, make sure you do it again because you do need those connected to the parts. At this point, friends, we can go over to the motor type and now we get to change things. We've got the continuous, servo, and stepper. We're going to be working with continuous. We've got the torque, speed, and max RPMs. And this is the magic part. We can now edit interactions. So we want to use the ASWD keys. I'm going to click on W and I'm going to give it the action of change speed by. I'm going to make it only while I hold it and I'm going to change this number to 50 and press enter. That's what's going to make it go forward. Well, the S key is going to make it go backward. So once again, click S. We're going to do change speed by while held and this one will be negative 50 and press enter. Now let's get our turning set up. Friends, we need to click on D. Once again, change speed by while held. And then this side needs to be negative 25. That took a little bit of testing to figure out. And A, of course, needs to be change speed by while held. And this time we need to put 25 and press enter. With those completed, we can now click back here and put these wheels and connections everywhere. Let's grab this wheel and do Control D, nudge it back to where we want to put it. I'm going to look at this from a corner so I can see if that alignment is what I like. It is. So now I'm going to grab both wheels. Notice I've got 4 shapes. Do Control D and nudge them to the other side. So now we simply need to adjust the motors over here. I'm going to make it easier by hiding this. And we're going to click on these and just edit the interactions for DNA to make them the opposites. So currently this was negative 25 on this side of the car. We need positive 25 and we need this one to be negative 25 and enter. Click down on this motor and once again, edit the interactions and make it the opposite. Positive 25 and A becomes negative 25. So this car will be able to turn like a tank. Friends, with our car built and the interactions in place, let's take it to Sim Lab and of course test it. Notice it takes a moment for the geometry to show up. Wait for that orange color to go away. Bingo, that's what it looks like when it snaps. Now we can hit play and let's test out our car. W is forward, S is back, and there is D, and there is A. How cool is that? Now let's quickly add an emergency brake. I'm gonna hit pause, reset. Let's hide the body of the car so it's easier to grab these. And I'm gonna grab two at once. Notice I'm in the shapes, continuous. I'm gonna edit their interactions and I'm gonna click on X and I'm gonna give it a set speed to zero. So that will stop those two wheels. Now I did not wanna grab all four because that would link their interactions. So once again, now I'm grabbing the left side and programming X to set speed to zero when it's pressed. While these are separate, I'm gonna take these and I'm gonna make them rubber just because that looks a lot more cool. Let's also set it to black. If we do show all, I can now click on my red block and I'm gonna switch it to polystyrene. That just makes it lighter and I'm gonna change the color. One more quick test. There is play, driving forward, turning, driving forward, backwards, and when you're in trouble, hit X to stop. How cool is that? Now friends, I am leaving a ton of room for you to explore and make this more awesome. Try the different modes, add more keys, see if you can actually get the wheels to turn instead of using tank mode. There's a lot of room for you to play. You can also connect these to all sorts of projects. Make sure you check out that blog post. The robot that was shared is absolutely fantastic. And of course, friends, make sure you stay tuned because there will be more projects coming soon. I do also want to highlight, I was a middle school teacher, so these lessons were designed for the classroom. Please try them out with your kiddos. See if you can get them trained up to make awesome things as well. Friends, I do want to say thank you to my supporters via YouTube memberships. You can, of course, check them out. There are three different levels, and all support is appreciated. Also, a huge shout out to my Patreon support group. Love how that group is growing. There's a sweet messaging area. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or smash subscribe. You're helping HL ModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.